Does that work? Yeah. Good morning. Glad you're all here. I hope you're enjoying the view. I'm Bjorn. I'm just a random person for now, because I'm only here to introduce you to Julius Foltz, founder of Prometheus and organizer of PromCon.
One of the founders and one of the organizers. So, thanks so much for coming and welcome. It's so exciting that the room is actually full now after half a year of, you know, trying to get everything into order. So I want to thank everyone for coming, but also I want to thank everyone who has ever contributed to Prometheus, whether it's a PR or you opened an issue for some bug or you helped someone on IRC, or maybe you're just pushing Prometheus in your company, or maybe you're giving talks somewhere. Like, that's like, all of this wouldn't have been possible without all your efforts. So thank you so much for that. Also, thanks so much for the people who are the core maintainers of Prometheus these days. I'm more, you know, freelancing around it and not doing so much on the upstream project right now, more community stuff. So thank you so much to them as well. I want to give a bit of perspective to, you know, how we got here. 4 years ago, Prometheus got started when Matt and I joined SoundCloud from Google. And we had the problem there that we already had a dynamic environment there, kind of like a Kubernetes-like cluster scheduler where everything is floating around dynamically. But we had monitoring tools that were made more for this kind of static age of things. So we had Graphite, StatsD, Ganglia, and so on. And they just didn't really cut it anymore for tracking down what was happening, especially in an outage or when you want to canary something. And we looked at the open source monitoring tools that existed and didn't really find one that we could extend in the way that we would be happy with it. Maybe we were a bit crazy also, but so we started Prometheus, started using it inside SoundCloud for a while, then gathered some first friends and outside users and contributors, but didn't really make a lot of noise about it. This changed in the beginning of last year in January, where we felt, okay, the system is ready and mature enough to present it to a wider world. Let's whip up a nice homepage. And we published a series of blog posts about it, tried to get on Hacker News. That didn't really work out at first by ourselves. I mean, I think if we got to the front page, then only somewhere at the bottom. But then 2 weeks later, someone who we didn't even know put it on Hacker News. It ended up on place number one. And since then, the growth suddenly really exploded. Like, we could see people flooding into our IRC channel, the pull requests and the mailing list and so on. So this is kind of the public birth of Prometheus, I would say. Then some companies started using it. It became more and more mature. We got contributors from all kinds of companies. But then the question kind of came, what's the governance of Prometheus? So is SoundCloud still controlling it? Is it an independent project? Or is there maybe one Prometheus company behind it that ultimately dictates its fate and might make some features closed source? So for people who are worried about that, we were also thinking, okay, maybe we should found some kind of foundation or find one that is willing to take us in. Luckily, around that time, the Cloud Native Foundation, the Cloud Native Computing Foundation, was founded as a sub-foundation of the Linux Foundation. And in May this year, we joined them after a bit of negotiation, and we joined as the second member project after Kubernetes. So we feel in really great company with this kind of dynamic systems, and we're for monitoring those. And this is kind of sending a signal to people that Prometheus is an independent open source project, not, you know, controlled by one company. Then there was still in the room that we were still 0.something, and, you know, when you upgraded Prometheus, you often had the problem that config file options changed or the storage format in the beginning even changed. Sometimes the HTTP API, you were never really sure. You had to check the changelog. So in July, just a bit more than a month ago, we released the first stable version of Prometheus. So that gives people really a signal that they can use Prometheus and build on it without worrying about so many, you know, update hurdles anymore. Then finally, what's the last step we need for success is, of course, a conference. That's happening today. This is not really time proportional. You can see, like, most of the stuff is happening. Most of the stuff is happening more towards the end. So I started thinking about PromCon in February 6th of this year, so it's been half a year of organizing that, and now some people helped me out as well. Brian, especially, with helping handling all the financials with his company, Robust Perception. Thanks for that. It's been an amazing ride, and now we're actually here. I want to show a funny graph of the most important stats. What's the most important stats for any open source project?
GitHub stars.
Of course, GitHub stars. So, I mean, that's a bit of a joke, of course, but I like this graph because it shows the history of the project a bit. So you see in 2012, at the end of it, we threw it on GitHub, we didn't tell anyone. Then some people started using it, and you know, there's a tiny bit of growth, then Hacker News happened, and then it's going up still, and it looks like the line is more than linear growth, which is a great sign. So in terms of the ecosystem, we have more than 350 people contributing code to the official repos in the Prometheus GitHub org, and more than 50 exporters and other kind of third-party integrations. Just in the last quarter alone, we had more than 350 articles about Prometheus or mentioning Prometheus. And companies that are using Prometheus are a really impressive list. These are just, you know, some that you might recognize, but there are so many others, like hundreds of others, small ones, big ones, and we've been totally blown away by that. So that's for, you know, why Prometheus, how we got there, basically, and back to some organizational stuff for this conference. Please, we encourage you to tweet about the conference. The hashtag is PromCon2016 with the number in there. Feel free to mention our Twitter account as well. There are lightning talks on both days from 5:30 p.m. to 6 p.m. The sign-up board is right there. You can just write yourself in if there's still a slot free. We already have a bunch of them in there. So they're all 5 minutes long. Don't take longer, please. So looking forward. There's an evening event today. It's about 10 minutes walk from here. So in that direction, it's an outside area, which is really nice. We have both inside and outside options, but today I think it's going to be so hot that outside is great. And the drinks are sponsored by CoreOS, so thank you very much for that. There's also going to be food there. So, you know, we have breakfast, lunch both days, and dinner today at this evening event. There's also a map in the schedule that shows you how to get there, but we probably will just walk together there and hopefully nobody will get lost. User surveys. So Brian is collecting user surveys from companies using Prometheus, and then we'll publish those on the Prometheus blog. There are already three or so, and we'll publish some more. But if you want your company and their usage of Prometheus featured on there, please write to Brian or just approach him in person. There's a code of conduct, so we want to make this a pleasant and harassment-free conference for everyone. So please, please, please read it and follow it. If you have a concern, please approach either me directly or someone else who has a green staff badge. Finally, big, big, big thanks to our sponsors. On one hand, it's really cool because it shows interest of companies in Prometheus. On the other hand, it wouldn't have been possible to create this conference in this way without them. There's so many costly items, the catering, the venue sponsored by Google, and then the professional video recordings, the evening party, all that, the swag, wouldn't have been possible without their help. So thanks a lot. Finally, the program is really packed. There's talks from small companies, big companies. I think the furthest away traveled speaker is from Japan. We have an attendee from Indonesia as well, so that's really cool, really exciting. And yeah, so actually the next talk is me again. So I think Björn will actually not announce me, but I'm saying thanks for now and taking like a 1 minute break. Thanks for coming.